everyone, today we are going to learn a new concept, which is how to implement a queue using two stacks. And it is a very popular programming question which was asked or is being asked in many interviews. Like recently it was asked during my mock interview, so I thought to explain this to you. So the basic overview is, the interview will ask you that you have to implement a queue operation, like the operations of the queue using two stacks. And suppose a queue is given and you have to perform all the queue operations using two stacks. Like to the user, it will be seen as the operations are performed in the queue. But in the backside, the operations are performed using stacks. So you have to implement in this way. So the interview is like wanting to see your approach to solve this problem. So first of all, I'll explain you the basic concepts of stacks and queues. So queue performs first in first out operation. Like the element is inserted in the rear part and it is deleted from the front part. First in first out. Okay. Now for the stack, it performs LIFO operation, that is last in first out. The elements are inserted one by one and the top element is removed first. This is the operation of stack, and the operations are performed only using one end, that is the top. Okay, insertion and deletions both happens from the stack top. And in the queue, the enqueue operation or the insertion operation happens at the end. The new element which will be inserted next will be inserted at the last. And the deletion or the dequeue operation will be performed from the front part. Okay. Now we have to perform these operations in a queue using two stacks. Like we have to demonstrate it like it is performing inside a queue, but we are using two stacks instead of it. So for enqueuing, the enqueue operation is in the insertion operation, and the insertion happens at the last or the rear part. But there is a stack, so first we are enqueuing 1, then 2 to 6. Let's enqueue it or insert it. 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So now all the elements are inserted. The enqueue operation is completed. Now the dequeue operation. In the dequeue operation, we have to first dequeue 1. But see, this stack is reversed because we are inserting one by one. So the last element will be the first element as per the queue. But we have to dequeue 2. So what can we do? We can pop out elements from the stack 1 and insert it into the stack 2. This is stack 1 and this is stack 2. So what we can do? We can remove elements from stack 1 and insert it into stack 2. So it will automatically come in the sorted manner or the reversed manner. 6 will be popped. So it will be at the bottom of the stack. Then 5, then 4, then 3, then 2, and then at the last or the top 1. So this is the basic structure of the queue, like the basic order of the queue in which the question was given. So then we have to dequeue 1. So we can easily dequeue, right? We can just pop the top element of the stack for 1. And we can perform all these operations one by one because the elements are in order only, in the same order as it is shown in the queue. Okay, so we can dequeue all the elements. So this was the logic of implementing a queue using two stacks. Like the basic operations are enqueue and dequeue. So we can insert the elements into the queue by using stack. Like we can just insert it, and then if we have to pop out the elements or perform the dequeue operation, then we have to pop out the elements from the stack, and then as we pop out, we will insert the elements into the second stack. So the elements will be in the order the queue elements are given. So if we have to dequeue, now the elements are in the order, so we can dequeue it easily. So this was the basic logic. and this is the algorithm. Like if we have to enqueue an item into the queue, because we are performing queue operation using two stacks. So to enqueue an item into the queue, push the item first into the stack. As I told you, we are pushing the items into the stack first. Okay, one by one, we are pushing in the order it is given in the input. For example, input is given as 6, 7, 3, 2, 5. So it is given in this order. So we will first insert 6, 7, 3, 2, and 5. And then for the dequeue operation, if both the stacks are empty, suppose if both the stacks are not having any element, so we are inserting elements, right? Before inserting, both the stacks were empty. So we were inserting elements. Then if S2 is empty, like here I have made a new stack. I made a new stack. As I have taken a new example, see, this was the input I have inserted or performed the enqueue operation. As the stack was empty, so I have enqueued all the items in the stack for performing the queue operation. Then if we have to dequeue, both stacks are not empty, one stack is full. But the second stack is empty, S2 is empty. So move the elements from S2, S1 to S2. See, we will pop the elements from the stack 1. Then insert it into stack 2. 5, 2, 3, 7 and 6. This is the order in which the elements are popped and inserted into the second stack. Now we can easily pop out elements, right? And then pop. And then if we have to perform the peak operation, like if we want the top element, then we can return the top element or the item from the stack 2. So this was the basic logic. And the time complexity of push and pop operations is O of 1. Because if we are performing push operation, then only one element is inserted. Then O of 1. And for pop also, O of 1. But we are performing it using stacks. And in one time, like the space is taken till the size of the input. Like here the size of input is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So O of 5 will be the space complexity, or O of n will be the space complexity. This is the time complexity. O of 1 is the time complexity, and O of n is the space complexity, because it is taking n space. Here also n, and here also n. So O of n in total. But sometimes we are performing the pop operation, like we are transferring all the elements of S1 to S2 fully. So it will take O of n time, because we are fully transferring the elements. Suppose if we want to dequeue 6, then we have to fully transfer this queue, this stack S1 into S2. So we have to remove all the items. So the time complexity will be O of n. But this will be only in some cases. Like not always we are popping all the elements. So this time complexity is the amortized time complexity. And what is that? Amortized time is the way to express the time complexity when an algorithm has the very bad time complexity only once in a while. And besides that, the time complexity happens most of the time. Like most of the time complexity was O of 1, because we are performing pushing and the popping operations one by one. But sometimes if we want to pop the last element or dequeue the last element in the stack, then we have to reverse whole stack. So only sometimes the time complexity will be O of n. So as per the amortized time complexity principle, we will take O of 1 as the push and pop time, because O of n will be happening only sometimes, and most of the times O of 1 will be the time complexity. So the time complexity is O of 1 and space complexity of O of n. Now let's see the code. See, I have taken a structure Q. In the queue, I have taken two stacks, S1 and S2. And for the enqueue operation, I am pushing the element x into s1, that is first stack. And then if I want to dq, we will check if both the stacks are empty. Then we have to print the queue is empty. Then if the second stack is empty, it means the first stack is having elements inside it. We have to check that if the first stack is empty or not. If it is not empty, we have to push the elements to the second stack. S1.top, we are pushing into S2. We are pushing the elements from S1 to S2, right? So this is the operation. And then we are popping elements from the stack. Like we are pushing elements from this S1 to S2 and then we are popping, right? And then if we have to return the items, the top item of the stack, we'll simply return s2.pop top and then we'll pop. And this is the operation in which we are inserting elements into the queue. NQ using stack. We have written NQ operation using stack and DQ also using stack. So I have called the NQ and DQ functions. So output will be 1, 2 and 3 only. See, 1, 2 and 3. As I told you, time complexity will be O of 1 and space will be O of n. Now I'll post this code in my description. Thank you.